You love me with an everlasting love. You love me with an everlasting love. You love. In your everlasting arms, you hold me. In your everlasting arms, oh, oh, I'm a little take my brokenness. And you heal me in the power of your love. You loved me first. You loved me first when I had nothing to offer you.
There is one and only one, all-sufficient basis for every provision of God's mercy and love. The exchange that took place on the cross. This is the Father's love gift for you. It is finished. No other price needs to be paid. Listen to these words of love and healing from your Father. My child, I am your father, and I love you with an everlasting love. You have never not been loved by me as your father. I am the Lord your God, and I heal you. In me, you live and move and have your being. Every good and perfect gift comes from me. If you make your dwelling place in me, no evil will befall you. No sickness will come near your dwelling. I give my angels charge over you. They will camp round about you if you fear me. And they'll deliver you from every evil and every attack. When you are wounded, I see you as beautiful and take pleasure in you. My thoughts toward you are always good and filled with hope. Even when you have sinned, I still love you and want you to sit beside me with Christ overflowing in my love. I am your Father who loves you so very much that I gave my Son Jesus to die just for you, so that you might know my love. I love you just as much as I love my Son, because you love Jesus. I desire only good things for you. It is not my will for you to suffer or be sick. I created a perfect world for you, where there was no sickness or disease, but sin entered and brought the curse. Sickness, disease, and oppression are a part of that curse. I sent my Son Jesus so that you could know my redemption. The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus came to give you life abundantly. In that abundant life, there is health, joy, and peace. All the evil that you justly deserve came on Jesus. So all the good due to Jesus because of his sinless obedience could be made available to you. Jesus was wounded for your healing. My Son bore your sicknesses and carried your pains. He was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for your iniquities. The chastisement for your peace was upon him that day. And by his stripes, you are healed. Jesus was wounded physically so that you might receive physical healing. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, you can ask whatever you desire, and it will be done for you. Whatever things you desire when you pray, believe that you will receive them, and you will have them. Ask me, and you will receive. Healing is my will for you. I am God. I do not change. Whatever you ask me, in Jesus' name, I will do. What I have promised, I am able to do, and I will do it.
For you created my inmost being. Your works are wonderful, I know full well. frame was not hidden when I was formed in the secret place. Your eyes saw my unformed being. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before the first one came to be. Thank you, God, for creating me. You cared enough to care for me. For you created my inmost being. Your works are wonderful, I know full well. My frame was not hidden when I was formed in the secret place. Your eyes saw my unformed being. All the days ordained for me are written in your book before the first one came to be. Thank you, God, for creating me. You cared enough to care for me. I love you. I love you, Lord. I love you. You, oh, I praise you, Lord. I praise you. I praise you, Lord. I am fearfully and wonderfully
Jesus told his followers, "If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father who is in heaven give good things to those who ask him?" Listen to these words from the Bible and receive them. "The words that I speak to you are spirit, and they are life." John 6:63. "Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away." Matthew 24:35. "Though rain and snow come down from the heavens and stay on the ground to water the earth, they cause the grain to grow, producing seed for the farmer and bread for the hungry. It is the same with my word. I send it out, and it always produces fruit. It accomplishes all I want it to, and it will prosper everywhere I send it." That's Isaiah 55:10. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. Proverbs 3, 5 through 8. You must serve only the Lord your God. If you do, I will bless you with food and water, and I will keep you healthy. Exodus 23, 25. And Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing all kinds of sickness and all kinds of disease among the people. Then his fame went throughout all Syria, and they brought to him all sick people who were afflicted with various diseases and torments, and those who were demon-possessed, epileptics, and paralytics, and he healed them. Matthew 4, 23, 24. In Exodus 15, 26, it says, if you will listen carefully to the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, obeying his commands and laws, then I will not make you suffer the diseases I sent on the Egyptians. For I am the Lord who heals you. And when Jesus went out, he saw a great multitude, and he was moved with compassion for them and healed their sick. Matthew 14, 14. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Isaiah 53. God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Acts 10, 38. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. Psalm 91, verses 9 and 10. When they had crossed over, they came to the land and anchored there. And when they came out of the boat, immediately the people recognized him, ran through the whole surrounding region, and began to carry on beds those who were sick to wherever they heard he was. Wherever he entered, into villages, cities, or the country, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they may just touch the hem of his garment. And as many as touched him were made well. Mark 6, 53 through 56. Suddenly a man with leprosy approached Jesus. He knelt before him, worshiping. Lord, the man said, if you want to, you can make me well again. Jesus touched him. I want to, he said. Be healed. And instantly, the leprosy disappeared. Matthew 8, 2 and 3. Then Jesus said to the centurion, go your way. And as you have believed, so let it be done for you. And his servant was healed that same hour. Matthew 8:13. Then the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. Matthew 21:14. When evening had come, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out spirits with a word and healed all who were sick, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, "He himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses." Matthew 8:16-17. Vast crowds followed him there, and he healed their sick. Matthew 19:2. And when he had come into the house, the blind man came to him, and Jesus said to them, "Do you believe that I am able to do this?" They said to him, "Yes, Lord." Then he touched their eyes, saying, "According to your faith, let it be to you." And their eyes were opened. Matthew 9:28-30. O Lord my God, I cried out to you for help, and you restored my health. Psalm 30:2. For I will restore health to you and heal your wounds, says the Lord. Jeremiah 3:17. But to you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings. Malachi 4:2. Jesus himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness. By whose stripes you were healed. 1 Peter 2:24. For he healed many, so that as many as had afflictions pressed about him to touch him. Mark 3:10. Then he healed many who were sick with various diseases, and cast out many demons. Mark 1:34. Jesus said to him, "If you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes." Mark 9:23. My child, be attentive to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them escape from your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them, and healing to all their flesh. Proverbs 4:20-22. So I say to you, ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. Luke 11:9-10.
Let your healing water flow through me. Wash away my sin and unbelief. Heal me with your mighty hand. Reveal to me your perfect plan. Let your will be done in me. Let your healing water flow through me. Open up my eyes and let me see. Your word I stand on and believe that healing is your will for me. Your tender love and mercy I receive. Healing flowed that day at Calvary, and it still flows today. Only one drop of His precious blood can wipe your pain away. Let your healing water flow through me. Wash away my sin and unbelief. Heal me with your mighty hand. Reveal to me your perfect plan. Let your will be done in me. Cause you're Jesus, my healer. Your health to my bones. You're the very strength to my body. And you are healing, healing to my flesh. And I praise you, I praise you, my Lord. And I thank you for what you're doing in me. I receive your will for me. Jesus, I believe.
Pleasant words are as a honeycomb, sweet to the soul, and health to the bones. Proverbs 16:24. The time is now for you to learn the power of faith-filled words. Jesus said, "He shall have whatsoever he saith." Mark 11:23. Repeat the words of this prayer with me. I thank you, Father God, that your word is true. It is for me, and I receive it. I thank you, Jesus, that you are my healer. I believe that you love me, and that it is your will for me to be whole and walk in health. I believe that you died for me, and that you suffered so I do not have to. Jesus, you took my sin and my sickness. And right now, I give it all to you, Lord. You were wounded physically, so I could be healed physically. It is your will and your desire for me to be whole and healthy, spirit, soul, and body. I give all my resentment, anger, hurt, and doubt to you. I forgive everyone who has hurt me, just as you have forgiven me. I will not allow anything to stand between me and my healing. Father, you created all things. Everything exists because of you. You know all things, and nothing is too hard for you. You make all things perfect, and you can and you will make me whole. Thank you, Father, that you give me salvation, life, health, joy, and peace. These are gifts from you, and I do not have to earn or achieve them. I only have to receive them, and I do receive them with thanksgiving right now. I will guard the words of my mouth, and I speak life and health to my body. I will think about the things that are good and worthy of praise. I will focus on you, God, and not on my problems or my pain. Father God, I will seek you first and trust you to provide everything I need. I purpose to walk according to your promises, not the problems of this world. I will not stagger at your word through unbelief. Instead, I am strong in faith, giving glory to God, being fully confident that what you promised will come to me. I am not moved by what I see, hear, or feel. I am only moved by what I believe, and I believe in you, Jesus, the author and finisher of my faith. I receive what you bought for me, Jesus. All your promises are mine. By faith in Jesus Christ, I am healed. Amen.
there's a healing stream from the throne of God, and it's flowing pure and deep and wide. God is calling out, saying, wait on in. It can make you whole, never the same again. There's a balm that soothes all fear and pain, and it's melting every hurt away. Refreshing oil of life, free to every man, can bring the sick to life again. Hallelujah, 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 amen. Hallelujah, 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 amen.
Forever. Oh, oh, oh.
I can look back on my history. The mountains and the valleys, you have been there every step of the way. You have been there every step of the way. You have been there every step of the way. You have loved me every step of the way. Good times and the bad times, you have always been there. Your love never fails, your love never fails.
It is written, all scripture is given by inspiration of God. For the word of God is living and powerful. The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. For I am alert and active, watching over my word to perform it. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. Forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. What he says he will do, he does. What he promises, he makes come true. There has not failed one word of all his good promise. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. My child, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life for those who find them, and health to all their flesh. Do not be afraid, only believe. All things are possible to them that believe. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. For assuredly I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. Yet you do not have because you do not ask. And whatever things you ask in prayer, believing, you will receive. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. Most assuredly, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. Again I say to you, that if two of you agree on earth concerning anything they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. To those far and near, and I will heal them, says the Lord. Heal them. Have faith in God. I tell you the truth, you can say to this mountain, go fall into the sea, and if you have no doubts in your mind and believe that what you say will happen, God will do it for you. So I tell you to believe that you have received the things you ask for in prayer, and God will give them to you. Because you love me, says the Lord, I will rescue you. I will protect you, for you acknowledge my name. You will call upon me, and I will answer you. I will be with you in trouble. I will deliver you and honor you. With long life will I satisfy you and show you my salvation. For I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear. I will help you, for I myself will help you, declares the Lord. I, the God of Israel, will not forsake you. I will make rivers flow on barren heights and springs within the valleys. I will turn the desert into pools of water and the parched ground into springs. But you, my servant, whom I have chosen, I took you from the ends of the earth. From its farthest corners I called you. I said, you are my servant. I have chosen you and not rejected you. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. For I am the Lord who heals you. I am the Lord who heals you. To the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. He who seeks finds, and to him who knocks, it will be opened. Now this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of him. For all the promises of God in Christ Jesus are yes, and in him, amen, to the glory of God through us. Let them shout for joy and be glad who favor my righteous cause, and let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified who has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant.